Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Welcome in the house of the Lord on this Transfiguration Lord's Day, when we join with our Methodist family in the Caribbean and the Americas to celebrate MCCa Men's Lord's Day. A warm welcome to all joining us on Facebook and YouTube. We also acknowledge the presence of our Superintendent Minister, the Reverend Dr. Joan Delsell Mead. We are glad that all of you can share with us in this act of worship, especially if you are joining us for the first time. We say thanks to the streaming team, our musician, the men of our congregation who will be actively participating in the service, and all others who contributed in making this worship experience possible. May your time with us be a blessing. At this time, the choir will sing the choral intro.
Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
O God, you are beyond words and description. Your love is beyond knowledge and explanation. Make our hearts ready to receive you as we gather to worship you.
Shine on us as we meet in your presence, O God, so that our lives may reflect the fullness of your glory.
The Lord reigns, let the earth rejoice.
Our God reigns, we shall be glad and wait for his word.
We lift our voices together and sing, lift every voice and sing.
Every voice and sing, till earth and heaven.
Let us all pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us adore and praise our God, Almighty and Eternal God. We worship and adore you. You are from everlasting to everlasting, creator and sustainer of all things created, visible and invisible. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Worthy are you to receive glory and honor, thanksgiving and praise.
We praise your name, O God Almighty, and we thank you for all we owe to your guiding and sustaining hand, for the many blessings you have bestowed on us in the past, and for the assurance that your goodness for us will never fail.
Above all, we bless your name for the grace and truth that are in Jesus Christ, for our redemption by his death on the cross, and the presence and comfort of your Holy Spirit in our hearts.
All praise and glory, blessing and honor, thanksgiving and worship be to you, O blessed Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Let us prepare our hearts for confession as we seek forgiveness from God while we sing seated the chorus, "Search Me, O God." Silence, confess our sins to God and pray for his forgiveness. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against each other, in thought and word and deed, in the evil we have done and in the good we have not done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of our sins.
Forgiving God, who have made us all and hate nothing that you have made, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all our sins. Create and make in us contrite hearts, that worthily lamenting our sins, we may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name.
Hear then this good news. Christ came into the world to save sinners. If we sincerely confess our sins, our God is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We are forgiven.
Amen. We are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
We stand as we sing our hymn of assurance, knowing that we are forgiven because we are so glad that Jesus loves us. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Message from the District MCCA Men's Commission's President, which has been prepared by Brother Sidney Matthew, and that will be followed by a special selection from the men.
MCCA Men's Lord's Day 2022. Message from the President, Brother Sidney Matthew. My brothers, I greet you in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, wishing that you will all experience God's richest blessing for a bright and prosperous New Year 2022. I am sorry that I was unable to send Christmas greetings, but the executive is working assiduously to correct that situation by establishing a medium for proper communication. Brethren, a new year has dawned, and a new era has begun and brought upon us around March last year. where a pandemic, COVID-19, changed the complexion of life worldwide. This pandemic, which was predicted going on 64 years ago to happen by the year 2021, is now upon us, but glory be to God, the omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent Father, knowing what will happen well ahead of time, inspired mankind to prepare for what's ahead, even though mankind generally does not know what will happen unless he acknowledges the predictions of others who might have been inspired by God to make such predictions. Went ahead motivated by the wisdom of God and created a medium to deal with such an occasion called a computer, whereby one could stay at his location and virtually communicate with others elsewhere, looking at and talking to them as if they were physically in the same place. My brothers, people the world over have taken this pandemic seriously and are taking precautions to stay alive. With these facts in mind, and the fact that we have been warned over 2,000 years ago of the coming of our Lord and Savior, shouldn't we take even more seriously that second coming of our Lord? If we do, we would realize the monumental task ahead for us. But no task is too huge while we depend on the power of Almighty God. We have been commissioned by our Creator to spread scriptural holiness throughout the land, to make disciples of all people, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us put our hands to the plow, pressing forward and depend on the power of our God to see us through. Despite the fact that you have not heard much since our meeting of July last, the Secretary, the Minister, and myself have had several discussions until we were able to establish a link with the other executive members. Now that the link has been established, we are trying to include representatives of all the circuits in this district. A meeting of the executive was held on January 6, 2022, where a number of issues and challenges were identified. And we plan that as early as the communication system is in place, to promote an all-inclusive approach toward addressing these concerns. My brothers, the executive is charged with the responsibility to chart the way forward, enhancing men's work and the work of our church generally. We take this responsibility seriously, and by God's help, we will. God's richest blessings upon us all. Sydney Matthew, Leeward Island District, MCCA Men's Commission President. We'll now have the special selection by the men.
At this moment in the service, we'll have a special walk-up offering for the men's work. The basket is here in front, so if you can please make your contribution to men's work, those who are here in chapel, and those who are online, you can do so also online by indicating men's work. We now turn to the Word of God. Just one moment, please. Let me thank everyone for their financial contribution to the men's work. And as I said, we now turn to the Word of God, and we will pray the collect together. O God, the Creator and Preserver of all humankind, thank you for sending Jesus as our perfect example of a godly man. We pray that we may all grow in grace and in the knowledge of Christ Jesus our Lord, and that we may become strong in the Lord and in his mighty strength, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We will now have our Old Testament reading, which comes from Genesis chapter 32, which will be read by Brother Emilio.
Good afternoon. The Old Testament reading is taken from Genesis chapter 32, reading from verses 9 to 12 and 22 to 30. And Jacob said, O God of my father Abraham, and God of my father Isaac, O Lord, who said to me, return to your country and to your kindred, and I will do you good. I am not worthy of the least of all the steadfast love and all the faithfulness that you have shown to your servant. For with only my staff I crossed this Jordan, and now I have become two companies. Deliver me, please, from the hand of my brother, from the hand of Esau, for I am afraid of him. He may come and kill us all, the mother with the children. Yet you have said, I will surely do you good and make your offspring as the sand of the sea, which cannot be counted because of their numbers. 22. The same night he got up and took his two wives, his two maids, and his 11 children, and crossed the ford of the Jabbok. He took them and sent them across the stream, and likewise everything that he had. Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him until daybreak. When the man saw that he did not prevail against Jacob, he struck him on the hip socket, and Jacob's hip was put out of joint as he wrestled with him. Then he said, "Let me go, for the day is breaking." But Jacob said, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." So he said to him, "What is your name?" And he said, "Jacob." Then the man said, "You shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel, for you have striven with God and with human and have prevailed." Then Jacob asked him, "Please tell me your name." But he said, Why is it that you ask my name?" And there he blessed him. So Jacob called the place Peniel, saying, "For I have seen God face to face, and yet my life is preserved." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our appointed psalm for today is Psalm 107, verses 1 to 16. At the end of the reading, we will stand for the Gloria. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Those who redeem from trouble and gather in from the lands, from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south.
Some wandered in desert wastes, finding no way to an inhabited town. Hungry and thirsty, their soul fainted within them.
Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them from their distress. He led them by a straight way until they reached an inhabited town.
Let them thank the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wonderful works to humankind.
For he satisfies the thirsty, and the hungry he fills with good things.
Some sat in darkness and in gloom, prisoners in misery and in irons, for they had rebelled against the words of God and spurned the counsel of the Most High.
Yeah. Their hearts were bowed down with hard labor. They fell down with no one to help.
Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them from their distress.
He brought them out of darkness and gloom, and broke their bonds asunder.
Let them thank the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wonderful works to humankind.
For he shatters the doors of bronze, and cuts in two the bars of iron.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Our epistle reading for today comes from 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 1 to 14.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Reading is taken from 2 Timothy, chapter 1, reading from 1 to 14. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, for the sake of the promise of life that is in Christ Jesus. To Timothy, my beloved child, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and Christ Jesus, our Lord. I am grateful to God, whom I worship with a clear conscience, as my ancestors did, when I remember you constantly in my prayers, night and day, recalling your tears. I long to see you so that I may be filled with joy. I am reminded of your sincere faith, a faith that lives first in your grandmother, Louise, and your mother, Eunice, and now I am sure lives in you. For this reason, I remember you to rekindle the gift of God that is within you through laying of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of cowardice, but rather a spirit of power, of love, and of self-discipline. Do not be ashamed, then, of the testimony about our Lord, or of me, his prisoner, but join with me in suffering for the gospel, relying on the power of God, who saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace. This grace was given to us in Christ Jesus, before the ages begun. But it has now been revealed through the appearing of our Savior, Christ Jesus, who abolished death and brought life and immortality to the light through the gospel. For this gospel, I was appointed a herald and an apostle and a teacher. And for this reason, I suffer as I do. But I am not ashamed, for I know the one in whom I have put my trust, and I am sure that he is able to guide until that day when I have entrusted to him. Hold to the standard of sound teaching that you have heard from me, in the faith and love that are in Jesus Christ. Guard the good treasure entrusted to you with the help of the Holy Spirit living in us. He ended the reading. May God add his blessing to the reading of his holy word.
We now stand for our gospel reading, which comes from Luke chapter 9, verses 28 to 36.
Glory to you, O God.
The gospel according to Luke chapter 9, verses 28 to 36, the Transfiguration. Now about 8 days after these sayings, Jesus took with him Peter and John and James and went up on the mountain to pray. And while he was praying, the appearance of his face changed and his clothes became dazzling white. Suddenly, they saw two men, Moses and Elijah, talking to him. They appeared in glory and were speaking of his departure, which he was about to accomplish at Jerusalem. Now Peter and his companions were weighed down with sleep, but since they had stayed awake, they saw his glory and the two men stood with him. Just as they were leaving him, Peter said to Jesus, "Master, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah," not knowing what he said. While he was saying this, a cloud came and overshadowed them, and they were terrified as they entered the cloud. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, "This is my son, my chosen. Listen to him." When the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone. And they kept silent, and in those days told no one any of the things they had seen. This is the gospel according to Jesus Christ.
Praise to Christ, O Lord.
We now turn to hymn 146, Come Divine Interpreter. Let the words from my mouth and the meditation from my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Amen. To those of you who know my speaking voice, I apologize if it sounds a bit scratchy, but nevertheless, the message that I have prepared for us today will be read, and my voice will not be deterred. I have chosen as the title of today's meditation, Worthwhile Struggle. Worthwhile Struggle. And this is based on the scripture lesson from the Old Testament, Genesis chapter 32, verses 9 to 12, and verses 22 to 30. The question I will ask you next may sound a bit strange to you, but I ask you to bear with me, so I may make clear what I hope for you to understand of my meditation of the scripture. Have any of you ever been in a physical fight? A real fight? So I'm talking about a real fight where you and another person are in hand-to-hand combat, sharing blows with each other? No? I'm sure not all of us are the good-mannered Christians that deserve as we sit here together and must have had some sort of rambunctiousness at some point in our lives. Hopefully I've not scared you with this talk, but there is no need to be alarmed. I'm quite sure some of us at some time or the other in our childhood or youthful years have had some form of conflict with our peers. I know I certainly have. Now, I don't want any one of you to think, or that I put in your mind, that I was some type of bad John who was constantly in brawls and throwing my weight around and beating the other person into submission. Far from it. But as children, some of us have had fights with other children. Actually, some of the times that I can recall that I was in a fight was with one of my best friends of that time. As a matter of fact, in my family and in his family, we consider each other family more so than friends. And that is how his mother and my mother have always lived with each other. Unfortunately, he has passed at a young age, and I dare say, in my view, too young an age, but my story is not about that. So back to our fights. What I can remember of the times that we fought is that the physical strain and fatigue that I felt during and after our fights. He not wanting to let me get the better of him, and I also not wanting him to get the better of me. But because neither one of us would let up on the other, the fights would end out of sheer fatigue, and eventually an admiration for each other. And unfortunately afterward, still each other's friend. In our scripture lesson today, from the Old Testament, from the book of Genesis, we read how Jacob was in a fight as he wrestled with God. The scripture does not indicate if Jacob was dreaming or if he came upon a man with whom he actually had a physical struggle. And in first instance, while reading the scripture, it is not even quite evident that Jacob was fully aware that the struggle he was having with this man all night long, that it was with God. Eventually, after Jacob could not get the better of the man that he was wrestling, he asked this man to bless him. I see here the mutual admiration that I mentioned earlier that I had in my fights with my friend, my brother. After having read the entire chapter of 32 of the book of Genesis, I realized that Jacob was actually running from a fight with his own brother Esau. And he even tried to appease him with gifts because he was convinced that Esau would kill him given the chance, or if not persuaded not to do so. But for some mystical reason, he did not seem to want to run from this fight he was having with this stranger. And he fought with all the strength he could muster until the man tells him to stop their fighting. Jacob also instinctively feels that he should ask this man to bless him before he lets him go on his way. And while reading the scripture, you may also find yourself thinking, why did God deem it necessary to simulate a fight with Jacob? Because obviously, being God, with all of God's infinite power, there is no way that Jacob would even have been able to hold out for that long, should God have unleashed a mere portion of his true power on Jacob. You would not even call it a fight. Each of us at some point or the other will struggle or will have struggled during our lives. But is struggle, depending on the context in which struggle may occur, necessarily a bad thing? Consider someone who has gone through struggle to overcome the odds of besting their intellect while achieving an education to become a physician, who may one day help in combating some dire illness that plagues the world. Consider the struggle of a teacher who may try his or her best to help some child, some student, to not lose sight of their potential and maybe showing signs of just letting it go to waste. Consider the struggle of a parent who may have to struggle just to keep their son or daughter of going down the wrong road, and if left so to do, completely destroy their lives, leaving their parents merely to watch this in anguish. I'm sure that you can see these are definitely worthwhile reasons to want to have that struggle. In the scripture lesson of Genesis, chapter 32, verses 9 to 12 and 22 to 30, we see Jacob in verses 9 to 12 wrestling with the thought that Esau will attack and kill him and his family, and he asks God to save him from his brother's hands. In the following verses, verses 22 to 30, there's a scene set for us where Jacob is actually caught up in an actual physical fight, as described by the scripture. Somehow, after reading the scripture many times, and I also asked myself, did this take place? Did this man, a real man, just like Jacob, flesh and blood, actually have a fight with Jacob? I would like to think that the scripture seeks to tell us, as God is demonstrating to Jacob, that we as God's children are worth fighting for. God won't turn his back on us, just as he did not turn his back on Jacob. And he continually fights for our love unto him, even though we are not deserving of this attention. But because he does not want us to turn our backs to him at the risk of our own peril, while thinking that we have all the answers and have no need for God. That struggle that God continually has with us is because God looks at us as worthwhile fighting for, because we belong to him. Pretty much the same way that a parent can feel about the fight that they are worthwhile having, and most certainly always do, for the sake of their child. May we always have in our hearts and in our minds open, and as we see and hear God's word, as he continually wrestles with us, that we also wrestle with God as he calls us unto him and offers us ample opportunities to redeem ourselves. Amen.
Thank Brother Orlando for that meditation on our struggle and of God's love for us. We respond with our hymn of response, Precious Lord, Take My Hand.
standing as we affirm our faith with the declamation of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated, as we will now have our prayers of recommitment and intercession. And before we have our prayers, we will sing, while seated, Sweet Hour of Prayer. Eternal Father, God of all creation, we glorify you and we thank you for the gift of fellowship, that the MCCa men and wider community of faith can meet together as one body to honor your name. May our perseverance be fueled by the desire to fulfill our Lord's command to follow me. Grant us the grace to continue fishing for men amidst the challenges we face. We pray for courage amidst prevailing uncertainties and for patience to press on, even when all around us seem hopeless and lost. May we accomplish the work you have given us to do. May we bring many to know you by the lives we lead.
Lord, hear mercy, hear our prayers.
We pray for the leadership of the Leeward Islands District Men's Commission, that they may be endowed with wisdom to lead the MCCa men. Increase their desire and zeal to carry out the tasks that beset them. We pray for individual circuit men's commissions, that they may find renewed joy in the doing of their assigned responsibility. May the anointing of your Holy Spirit overflow, and may your goodness and love follow them throughout all the days of their lives.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray for the Church Universal, and in particular the Methodist Church in the Caribbean and the Americas, for Connectional President, Bishop the Reverend Everell Gailbreth, and the other Connectional Officers, for our Bishop, the Reverend Charles A. Seaton, our District President, and the other District Officers, for the Bishops of the other districts, for our ministers and those in training, for all preachers, stewards, class leaders, and assistant leaders, leaders of organizations, and for all who are involved in the broad ministry of our church, that they may be constantly be renewed in faith.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Help us to remember that we are brought together as one body of believers through Jesus Christ, your Son. Renewed by the Holy Spirit for witness and service, may the Church be that bright beacon of hope, peace, joy, and justice that glorifies you across the region. May all barriers be broken down as the Church reaches out to those who have not yet accepted you as their Lord and Savior.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
O God, our refuge and our strength, our very present help in trouble, in this challenging and uncertain time of global pandemic and public health crisis, we come before you, offering our prayers on behalf of those in need, the Church and the world. We pray for the world leaders and health and well-being, who themselves face risks to their health as they serve the wider community. Equipped with reliable and accurate information, leading by example, may they serve our common humanity with unconditional love.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray that the leaders of different faith communities, leaders from the government, civil society, and the scientific community, work together with humility and mutual respect across boundaries and borders to overcome this pandemic. Give wisdom to those in power in government and institutions to make the decisions that will be for the good of all. Help your people discern how best to keep each other safe. We pray for leaders of the pharmaceutical industries worldwide that access to the vaccination against COVID-19 may be granted to the most vulnerable everywhere, regardless of their purchasing power.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray for healing for those who are sick, especially those infected with the COVID-19 virus. May they have access to medical care as they regain their health and strength. For those who have already lost loved ones to the virus, may they know the consolation of your love. Sustain and support the anxious. Lift up those that are brought low, that they may find comfort knowing that nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray, Lord, for people all over the world who live in conflict zones, and especially currently for the people of Ukraine who are now experiencing war. Dear God, be with the people of Ukraine and other conflict zones as they consider staying or fleeing. Be with the refugees that they may find a welcome to their distress. Comfort all families who have lost and will lose loved ones during this conflict and all conflicts. Give wisdom to those in power and governments around the world to make the decisions that will de-escalate this conflict and others.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We now have a moment of silence for your own personal petitions. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We will now chant the Lord's Prayer.
Father, lift your dim heaven,
We invite you now to offer your tithes, gifts, and offering towards the support of the work of the Lord. For those of you joining us virtually, the church's bank account number are now displayed on the screen for your convenience. We will now have the offering taken. Let us pray. God of the universe, thank you that your promises are sure. You are faithful. We can rely on you. Your word says that we will find joy in offering our time, talents, and money to meet the needs of others. Help us to give freely, sacrificially, and cheerfully towards the work of your kingdom. May you cause the seeds that we sow to grow into well-watered, fruitful trees of life. Lord, bless us and keep us. Make your face shine upon us. Turn your face towards us and give us peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
I believe things are always a bit different since we've had COVID for 2 years now. I guess we kind of forgotten what we're supposed to sing after receiving the offering. just let's say we. You sing, we give thee, but I owe.
Give me, but I owe. Whatever gifts may be, all that we have is thine alone. Our trust, O Lord, from thee. Amen.
At this time, I'd like to thank all my fellow brothers who have helped me during this service. I'd like to thank the live stream team. And now we can close our worship today and continue worshiping during the week while we sing and stand on the promises of our Christ.
Standing on the promises of Christ my King, to eternal ages let His praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing, standing on the promises of God.
As I said, we continue to worship during the week. We thank God for His promises indeed. And we can go refreshed into this world because, as the district team says, we can trust God in difficult times and He will help us transform the obstacles into opportunities. We say the benediction together. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ,
the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen.
Of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.